Hi, this is Rofiner. Welcome to this new tutorial about noise reduction with Darktable. Today I will use Darktable 3.0 and I will focus on the new stuff in Darktable 3.0 for noise reduction. I hope that the new features will ease your denoising and will give you better results. So basically for this tutorial, I've taken several images with different ISO value and some images underexposed. I will go to the darkroom. So for these images, which is my reference, I've put an exposure module in automatic mode, so that the correction is of 0 EV. And I will just copy paste this on all images to have the same visual exposure. So I will focus on denoise profile because it is the module that has been updated in Darktable 3.0. And the first thing I want you to notice is that the parameters, the default parameters of the modules, are no longer independent of the ISO, because the parameters set here for this ISO are different than the parameters here for a higher ISO. And if I go to an image with an even higher ISO, I've got different parameters again. So basically, Darktable will now try to change the default parameters depending on the profile, so that you can get a one-click denoising, which erases quite well the noise. As new features, there are also two new modes, the auto modes. It aims at making your life easier, because as you can see, there are quite a lot of sliders here to change, depending on what you want to do. And basically, in auto mode, you have one slider which is adjust auto set parameters, which changes several underlying sliders of the manual mode. So basically, how to denoise an image? Just go to auto mode, and then you've got these three sliders. Usually I reduce the strength to 0.7, to smooth a bit less. You have the central pixel weight, which will basically be useful to recover some details, and which can be used to smooth the colors while preserving the luminance noise, while preserving some grain. Just as a reminder, luminance and chrominance noise doesn't exist in practice. It's just the way we perceive noise with our eyes as false colors and false erroneous luminosity. But in fact, the noise is just random noise on red, green and blue channels, and the fact that the noise is different on these channels gives us false colors and false luminance. So basically, this can give you some flexibility to get back some luminance noise, as you can see, and some details. And there is this slider, the adjust auto set parameter. We will see that it can be really useful on underexposed images or images where you apply a strong amplification in the shadows, for example, If you use Filmic RGB, if you have a really low middle gray luminance, you will probably see quite some noise in darkest area, and this slider will be useful for this. Just as a side note, you can also use the blending mode, uniform blending mode, and lower the opacity if your image is not so noisy. Even without denoising, you can, for example, set opacity to 70% or a bit more, depending on your tastes. Also, keep in mind that here we see the image at 100% zoom level, which is required to have an accurate preview to see exactly what will get exported if the image is not resized, or if it's resized but with high quality resampling. And that's why we are 100% zoom level. But keep in mind that you will probably see the image from unzoomed once it's exported, so you can keep some noise at this zoom level. If you can still see some noise, it's not a problem. So now let's dive into this parameter, the adjust autoset parameter. Here I'm on an underexposed image. See that we have 3 eV of exposure approximately. This is the result I get with the noise profile, and you can see that there are some areas which are a bit purple, some areas which are a bit green, greenish. It's not perfect, and it's because of the underexposure, and we have to tell Darktable to change the parameters. To change the parameters because we have more noise than what Darktable believes. So basically, I will increase this slider until we get a better result. We already get a better result here with the value 2. We can get bigger value if we want. Another example on this image with 4 eV on of underexposure. I will do the same thing. Here we can see maybe better than before that we have some yellowish and some purple and some greenish areas. It's not really beautiful. We will increase this slider until it gets better. And here, 4 is not a hard limit. You can give higher value with the keyboard. For example, the value 8. And this is the case for almost all sliders of this module. So don't hesitate to try values which are higher than the limit you see. So here, there is no more chroma noise visible. So that's the purpose of this slider. So here with the auto mode, you can denoise an image very quickly by just setting the strength and then using this slider to change several parameters at once. The good thing is that if you return back to the manual mode, it will keep the parameters which were decided by this slider. So for example, if I change this slider, it will change several sliders in the manual mode. So you can basically start with auto mode, do a lot of change into it to have some good first start, and then switch back to manual mode to be able to change each parameter at once. Each parameter individually, sorry, to fine-tune your denoising. So now I will explain the different parameters, and for that I will get a different image, this one. Okay, so as I said, I start with the auto mode. And try to get some decent results. Okay, a bit more maybe. Okay, then I can switch back to manual mode and I can change the different parameters. The first one is the patch size. What is the effect of the patch size? Let's take a look at very low value, what we get. Here we get a lot of noise remaining. And if I increase it just by one, we will see that all noisy pixels which were alone were filtered, but there remains some pixels, some aggregate of noisy pixels. And as I increase the patch size, I will get less and less aggregates like this. And it will smooth larger aggregates. If we compare with the patch size of 8, we can see that the edges are a bit blurred when we use big patch size. But when we have a patch size which is too low, they won't be as straight as they should. They will probably be affected by the noise. Okay, so next parameter is the search radius. Basically, the non-local means work by doing some average around each pixel, and this search radius is used to set how far we can use pixels for the average. Basically, to see the effect, scattering is a slider that was introduced to be able to do almost what does the search radius, but without performance penalty. Because search radius has a huge performance penalty when you increase it. So I suggest to keep it to 7 or reduce it if you want more performance, but 7 is nice, I think. So see, with search radius which is too close, we get some really ugly color noise. And scattering allows to get a bigger search zone to involve pixels which are more far from the pixel we are denoising for the averaging. So basically, increase the scattering if you see some nasty groups of pixels which gives you aggregates of color noise like this. And just like the central pixel weight or the strength, search radius and patch size, maybe not search radius, but you can give values which are above the limit using the keyboard. You can do that for preserved shadows because of it has no meaning to give values which are higher or lower than the limits for this particular slider, but for all slider you can do it. Central pixel weight, we've seen already what it does. Strength controls the amount of smoothing. And preserved shadows allows to control how much we smooth shadows comparing to highlights. So basically, giving huge values, we smooth the highlight more, and giving a really low value, we smooth the shadows much more. And basically, in previous version of Darktable, it was just like if preserved shadows were always at the value of 1. So you can see that in darker areas, we were better in terms of denoising with a value which was lower than 1. And the last parameter is the bias correction. The bias correction aims at correcting some bias that you can have in the darkest areas of the image. Sometimes when you have a very noisy image, the darkest areas can be purple or greenish. And this slider allows to correct that. It's not really the case for this image, so I will force it a little bit so you can see the effect. When we do color smoothing with Demosaic, it usually turns a bit shadows into purple. So I can lower the bias correction because shadows are a bit too purple, or increase it if shadows are too greenish. So here I want my shadows to become a bit more green, and here we are. So basically that's all for denoising with Darktable 3.0. The wavelets haven't changed since last version. It just has two more scales, but there has been no more change to this mode. What I suggest you is to use the non-local mean auto modes and switch back to manual modes if you need one of these sliders. And I hope you will enjoy these new features. So see you soon for another tutorial. Bye.